From Charlottesville to Seattle to Houston, white nationalist rallies and protests are popping up all over the country more frequently. Some end in violent clashes, especially when the anti-fascists or Antifa show up to counter-protest. Others, like this one in Houston, were not violent because there were no counter-protesters there. The rallies are generally set up by white nationalists and are attended by neo-Nazis and white supremacists and racists and bigots, all of whom show up to try and make a point. They have one general reason for doing so. They want to recruit other white people to their cause. The image these racist groups are hoping to convey is, look, join us. This is normal. We want a white America, and that idea shouldn't be shunned, but embraced by this country. In other words, these groups want to be normalized. According to several of the organizations that track hate groups, the number of people joining these hate groups is up, as are hate-related incidents. They saw a spike, especially during the election cycle of 2016. Here are a few reasons for that. Now, part of the rise in the numbers of people knowing about this and maybe wanting to join has to do with the internet. It has to do with marketing, if you will. These groups are on Facebook, they're on Twitter, they're on Reddit, they have their own websites. They are trying to get their message out any way they can, and it is working. In particular, they're looking to recruit young people, college students. There are flyers, for example, going up on campuses and other public spaces, trying to show them that this is the kind of America that they really do want to live in. In other words, the hoods are off and the button downs are in.
We've seen white supremacists try to recruit on college campuses for years. But what's different today is there has been a velocity and a volume of these efforts that we've really never seen before.
Now, I spent some time talking to a few of these neo-Nazis and some of the white nationalists and white supremacists who are trying to get their message out. White nationalist Jared Taylor, who sat down and talked with me, said that he wasn't a racist. On the other hand, he also told me that he believed that black people are, by their very nature, less intelligent than whites.
If whites do nothing, they will be reduced to a minority in which their culture is a sideshow.
He says his online publication is more popular than it ever has been before. Then you have guys like Robert Ray, otherwise known as Asmodor. Now, he's a contributor to one of the most popular and disturbing neo-Nazi websites.
I hate the Jews because they are behind all this. And they have been doing this for 2,000 years.
The neo-Nazi website that he writes for fully endorsed Donald Trump because the people behind the website believe that Donald Trump is with them. Why do they believe that? Because of his xenophobic language during the campaign and also because of his mixed messages on what happened in Charlottesville.